tell us your name one more time.
World rapper man, Ajaro David Obaru.
So you started this rapper, you know, you started running in your rapper. Tell us how big and how long is this rapper?
Well, I started running with the rapper in 2010.
Yes.
The first half marathon was Bucharest International Marathon.
Bucharest?
Yeah,
in Romania.
In Romania.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was the first time I was allowed to use the rapper to run. And the rapper is 20 yards long. I have another rapper, which is the world record, the longest rapper in the world.
How long is that one?
37 yards.
Wow.
It's actually, I called it a unity rapper because each yard represents a state in Nigeria.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
It would be great to see that.
Yeah, that rapper is with the NTDC as we speak.
Okay.
Because it was given to government as our own contribution.
So you said that your running a rap was inspired by your Robo background culture.
Yes. My interest is to know that the Robo culture will go out of its extinction. You might not see it in another 50 years if we're not careful.
Hmm.
And 91, 92, I first started rapper to an event in Uniben. After that event, I realized that it was an Robo Day event in University of Benin.
Hmm.
But the Robo boys that came, they were wearing jeans and trousers, suits. I was the only young person that was a tiny rapper and two other persons or so. So I just told myself that, well, if this thing is going to go out of fashion, one has to try to begin to encourage people. If we can wear our jeans, why not try once in a week or two, tie a wrapper? It makes no difference. It makes you unique, as a matter of fact.
Mm. And apart from this rap, apart from the length of the wrapper, it also weighs significantly.
Yes, the wrapper weighs more than 4 kg.
Wow.
And once it's soaked when I'm running, the
it
weight
weighs more.
More.
Yeah. And does it wear you down when you're running?
It does. That's why we finally said, let's have a wrapper challenge. It's supposed to be a wrapper marathon, but it will not sound right. It's a challenge.
Okay.
So we're calling it a wrapper challenge, you know, because it's a challenge to run marathon, one, and you're running with extra 4 kg or more loads.
When is the first time you ran a full marathon?
Full marathon is just recently.
Okay.
6th of February, Lagos City Marathon.
Okay.
That was the first time I ran a full marathon.
In your rapper?
Yes.
And what was your time?
My time was 8 hours, 5 minutes. I was actually the last person that day. But like I always tell people, marathon race is not all about being the first. If you're not an elite runner, everybody that runs a marathon have a reason for running.
Hmm.
And I ran that day to support two different NGOs.
Okay.
One is Food Click and Africa. Food Click is an NGO in Nigeria here that feeds people for free. And every step I took that day was, I said, support, donate to Food Click, not me. And then that's why I made sure I finished my race that day.
And, you know, you said that, you mentioned the place of marathon in leadership. Explain that.
Well, you see, marathon is not a sprint. Leadership is not a sprinting at all. And if every leader can inculcate the spirit of marathon running, like I tell people, when I'm running marathon, I use the spirit of the Olympic spirit, which is the spirit of finishing up. If every leader inculcate the spirit of marathon in their race in life, especially, let's narrow it to Nigeria. I don't see Nigeria overtaking the US in another 50 years. Likewise, I don't see myself, no matter how I train now, in another 20 years, I cannot beat Gabriel Selassie in marathon running, except God intervenes. So I say leadership and marathon, the correlation and what you need to learn from each is this. Our leaders should have this spirit in mind, finishing up well. When I started running with the rapper, people say, you are crazy. Your own self. We don't understand you. Why are you always thinking the other way? I say, well, to me, it's part of the creativity in me. I'm not bragging. I'd never set out to run with rapper the first time. I just said I want to be the first person to tie the longest rapper in the world. That was my dream. And when that dream didn't come true, I just like, what else do I need to do with my rapper? As a social entrepreneur, it just came to me that, look, you can run with your rapper. You can draw attention to different causes. And that's why I started doing that.
Have you received government patronage or even sponsorship from, you know, companies or private individuals to support this laudable cause of yours?
No government sponsor, no patronage, no.
Yeah.
No. Individuals, yes. People, I say close friends that have sacrificed their time. My last Lagos Abuja, I worked with some fantastic people. There was one guy from, he has his own company, it's called Afro Keys. He's a private guy, he's in the aviation sector. He volunteered to be my base manager for over 30 days.
Mm.
I can call him 2 a.m. that, look, I'm in so-and-so forest. I'm in so-and-so. I wake him up, he's a family man. But that guy sacrificed for me, Albert. My Lagos Okpekwe Abuja trip was safe. I was not getting support from anywhere. But people, private citizens, were doing citizen reporting.
Okay.
They were taking pictures, sending to Facebook channels. You know.
So
I didn't have anybody to
sponsor that. You mentioned that you really are planning a rapper challenge. You know, is this something you want to talk about now or no? Or still in the planning stage? You don't want to reveal it yet.
It's still in the planning stage, but I will encourage those who want things to work in this country to come on board.
Yeah.
Because you see, marathon or sport is a big event.
Yes.
If we can keep the momentum for another 4 or 5 years, it's going to begin to bring in returns. I want to see us doing this rapper challenge this year. I've been saying since 2013, or next year, or because nobody's coming on board, sponsorship is not coming, and I always keep postponing it. But I hope people will pick interest this year. We can start this year, I'll be glad for me.
And, yes, go ahead.
And it might interest you to know that I'm planning running Nigeria.
Okay.
Yeah.
I wanted you to mention that.
Yeah, running Nigeria is going to be a project that will cover over more than 1,500 kilometers. I'm going to run from Lagos, around circumvent the northeast of, come to Lagos, Oyo, Kwara, Niger, Kebbi, Sokoto, Zamfara, Katsina, Kano, Kaduna, Abuja, Nasarawa, Bauchi, come back to Benue, Ebonyi, Enugu, run like that, south, come back to Delta, Edo, Ondo, Ekiti, like that, back to Lagos.
How many days do you think that would take?
We're hoping, because of unforeseen circumstance, I'm looking at doing it on that 60, 90 days. Well, if you've not heard about Rapperman, I'm not bragging, but to the glory of God, I'm the only man that runs marathon with rapper in the world. My dream is to see people come run marathon in Nigeria with rapper. People used to tell me some 3-4 years ago that Rapperman is Photoshop, that it's not possible to run marathon like the way I do. Not until I started doing it in Nigeria, even Nigerians. My encouragement to others is, whatever you're doing, be creative in whatever you're doing. Don't give up. Someday it's going to work. And I see Nigeria coming back on its feet.